something.
Joining me now is one of the Democrats who was there, New York Congressman Gregory Meeks, and also Matt Schlapp, the chairman of the American Conservative Union and former political director for George W. Bush. And Congressman, I'll start with you on this. Your reaction to the Speaker of the House and other Republicans dismissing what you and other members did as a stunt?
Stunt. There's nothing that John Lewis does that's a stunt. John Lewis is a legendary individual. He doesn't have time for stunts. He has times for points and tactics so that we could bring to the floor what 90% of Americans know makes reasonable sense to do, and to try to get the individuals on the other side, the Republicans in the House, to at least bring a bill to the floor. One of the things that you can say that at least took place in the Senate, they had a debate, and everybody then could vote on whether up or down, however they did. The least we should be able to do in the people's House is to have a vote, and that's what that was all about, is to have a vote on two bills, a bipartisan bill, a bill, it was Peter King's bill. So it's not all that what the Democrats want, it was a vote where 90% of Republicans are also in support of it. So it wasn't a stunt. It was a tactic that you want to try to show what was taking place and to try to get something done, because we're tired, sick and tired of coming to have the stunt of just having moments of silence and nothing of substance done after that.
Yeah. Voice is the way it is because you haven't been to sleep yet.
I've been to sleep.
A couple people have asked me, well, okay, if the idea was to stop all progress in the House, not let anything happen, number one, why did the Democrats then allow those two votes to happen overnight? And why did they essentially end it? Why did you guys end it today and allow the House to adjourn?
Well, you couldn't prevent those votes from happening, number one. So even though, you know, there could not be the regular business of debate, we didn't allow that to happen, but the votes and the way the speaker did, there was no way that you could prevent that from happening.
Yeah.
And so in the dead of night, they wanted to get out of town. They didn't want to be confronted. We asked them to come and debate with us if they want to talk about why not put the bills on the floor.
Sure.
And what are their positions with regards to closing the gun show loophole and making sure that if you're on the no-fly list, you can't get on the, you can't buy a gun.
Yeah.
And we can have that debate.
Sure. But, you know, Matt, then, you know, to the point that the congressman is making, if Republicans believe that they have the better side of the argument about keeping people who are on the terrorism watch list, allowing them to still go into a gun store and legally purchase a gun, if Republicans believe they have the better side of the argument, why not debate? Why not allow a vote, an up or down vote, and see where it goes?
Well, it happened. They had the vote. They had the vote in the Senate.
In the House, I mean.
Well, but let's face it. They had the vote in the Senate. Whereas, you know, it's easier to bring things to the floor. And they didn't have the votes to pass it. And many Democrats didn't support the measure, which would have given the FBI 3 days to make sure somebody who's on the terrorism watch list should actually be on the terrorism watch list. As we all know, we've been reading about it all day. And for the last couple of days, Americans who are inadvertently put on the terrorism watch list, it can take up to 8 years to get your name back off of it. And we shouldn't abridge someone's constitutional rights on a whim. There ought to be a process. And there's a way to accomplish this. It is not by having a sit-a-buster on the floor of the House. Well, the congressman knows good and well the way you overturn the majority when you're in the minority in the House is simply get the votes for a discharge petition, and we will be voting
on
it.
First of all, Matt, that's very clever. You came up with a clever moniker, but the reality is it's easy to get things to the floor of the House. The Speaker of the House could simply bring a bill to the floor. The House has refused to vote. You just made an argument. Hold on a second. You just made an argument on what you believe is the substance of having people on the terrorism watch list still be able to buy guns. Why not, in a body that is designed to deliberate and vote, why shouldn't the House of Representatives allow a debate and a vote? And I'm talking about House. Don't pivot to the Senate.
Well, look, I have no problem with having a vote on this. I have no problem with voting on all these questions, because at the end of the day, defending someone's constitutional rights with the clear letters in the Constitution, the words of the Constitution make it clear that we shouldn't abridge that right on some kind of willy-nilly procedure.
Well, why do 90% of the American people want people who are suspected of being terrorists to not be able to buy firearms? The majority of Americans disagree with you.
Joy, I don't disagree with that. I do not want terrorists. First of all, I don't want terrorists to be in our...
But Republicans are making sure that they can.
Well, let me talk for Republicans. Republicans don't want terrorists to get guns.
But they're making sure that they can.
No, that's untrue. The fact is they had a vote in the Senate today, and the Democrats didn't support
this common sense measure. They're putting it on the Democrats. Congressman Meeks, he's throwing it on the Democrats.
No, it's a fact. Look at the vote today.
Congressman, the floor is yours.
Number one, you are absolutely right, Joy. Number one, we're two separate bodies. The Senate had a debate on the floor. You vote up or down. Then your constituency knows where you stand. And we have not had a vote on the House. And not saying that we don't know who would win or who'd lose, but at least your constituents and the American people will know where you stand. It is a major issue that we're confronted with every day in the United States of America now. Whether you're talking about the kind of mass shootings that have taken place, or you're talking about the other 30,000 deaths that has taken place in the United States of America. You know, as horrible as it was in Benghazi, where we lost four Americans, the Republicans have spent hundreds of millions of dollars to try to figure out how do we fix that and what happened there. And here we have 33,000 people that die. You don't want to go a step with even to take a vote so that we can make sure that we save a life.
And that is a relevant question. What policy, very quickly, Matt, do you support in order to try to reduce the 33,000 deaths a year via firearms? What is the policy you support?
Very simple. I would like to prevent all the deaths of those people in that Orlando nightclub by making sure terrorists don't get weapons. It was the Obama administration and the FBI
that took that person
off the terrorism watch list, Joy.
No, actually, he passed the background check and was able to get a gun, and your party says he should continue to be able to do it.
Because the FBI bungled the investigation.
Joy, you don't have to defend
the Obama administration. That's not your job. It's to let me speak as well. And the fact is that the things you're advocating wouldn't have stopped what happened in Orlando. This is about
terrorism. Name one policy, Matt, that you support that could pass the House and the Senate that your party would be willing to bring to the floor of the House that would actually reduce the 33,000 gun deaths, which include suicides, which include partner homicides, which include the mass shootings in places like Sandy Hook,
Charleston.
Sure.
Number one, we ought to take the mental health records and have them be part of the background checks. That's the first thing. The second thing is terrorists in this country should not have weapons. And under the Obama administration, we've seen two atrocities, San Bernardino and Orlando. I'm against
that's
it. I think the American
that's
people.
Attacking
yes,
the administration.
It is.
I got it.
Attacking terrorism is a policy.
Got it.
Joy,
all right.
Thank you very much.
Congressman Gregory Meeks and Matt Schlapp. They're very loud. Matt Schlapp. Thank you very much. All right.